1975, drummer Lenny White had risen to the top of his field, having graduated from Miles' early 70s band to play in the celebrated Mark II lineup of Return to Forever. And in 1975, White released his debut solo album, Venusian Summer, and from that album, the opening track, Chicken Fried Steak. Hear that dirty tone? That psychedelic, like, kind of squeezing, greasy sound. Ah, just crude and distorted. Yeah, it's really greasy. I love the way that those chords are just kind of like slide down, kind of like they're sliding. It's meant to invoke greasiness. Yeah, those sounds are meant to invoke like greasy boiling, like. Like, wah, wah, wah. Okay, I'm dying to know who's responsible for some of the other sounds we're hearing. Let's see, lead guitar on this track, Doug Rodrigues. And that's, let's see, 18, yeah, that's not a name I'm terribly familiar with. 18 credits in all, according to his GOGs, 14 instruments and performances. Let's see. He was on Santana's Santana's great 1972 Latin jazz rock album. And Welcome. Yeah, a few. He was on the self-titled debut by Bette Davis. Yeah, on some good stuff. Oh, that Giants record from 1971, released in 78, yeah. So he's kind of like on the precipice on the nexus between psychedelic rock, jam rock, and this, which explains the kind of dirty kind of psych tone that we're getting. Once again, very greasy, just sizzling. Yeah, F sharp. Gotta know, let's see. This is really bringing the bass to the fore. Doug Rauch. Or Rauch. Doug Rauch. Sorry if I... Oh, this guy left us very young. Died of a heroin overdose in 1979. Oh my God. When he was only 29 years old. Yeah, and he was also... A lot of these guys are kind of from the Santana early 70s band. Oh, this guy was also on that Jose Chipito Arias album. Yeah, good one. Oh, and Shigeru Suzuki's Bandwagon album. Oh, and the first Carly Simon. So this guy has been around a lot of places. Listen to that funky organ. Oh God, look at it. Listen to the way the organ, that kind of almost like choked organ sound is interacting with that bass line. This guy's great on the four string. And of course, the like kind of like cymbal laden drum rolls of Lenny White, quite, you know, tactile, quite delectable, just pacing it. God, these sounds are just like so fractious. I can't think of many songs that quite combine this much funkiness with like dirty psych sound, and yet also such tonal clarity, and tightness of it, tonal clarity between instruments and really tight playing. Like I've heard like kind of looser kind of psychedelic funk jams that were kind of, I don't know, just sort of soupy. Wow, wow, wow. Or hear that kind of Leslie tone? Maybe that's what it is. Maybe kind of a distorted Leslie, kind of a mixture of effects. God, throwing in a lot of scaly bits there. I think there's a couple of guitarists credit. Let's see, on rhythm guitar, Raymond Gomez. Yeah, more familiar name from, oh, and organ, yeah, the one and only Jimmy Smith, yeah, the great soul jazz supremo who had been recording, yeah, Jimmy Smith, dozens of records on Blue Note in the soul jazz vein, going back to 1956. Yeah, I figured, I was thinking it kind of had that sort of, I imagined it was one of those guys, yeah. Lenny White is really just being restrained on this. He's really letting the soloist, he's really letting the people that he surrounded himself with on this really just take turns at the spotlight while he just kind of sits there and back, just kind of, you know, pacing and accenting things. God, I cannot tell you who my favorite soloist on this is. They're all just so. It's like the last one I always heard. I guess this track is kind of like a three-man show, really, between Jimmy Smith, Doug Rodrigues, and Doug Rauch. God, hear Jimmy Smith, those, like, high keys. Oh, Lenny White's really starting to throw in some more, like, fills. Now he's really challenging them. God, hear those rolls, hear those. He's been restraining it the whole time, and now he's just kind of taking over. I think we're about to, we're about to go back into the intro section now, the tight kind of ensemble. God, this should have been used in something, like a... I wonder what kind of, this needed to be, this music needed to have been used in some kind of show. Or at least certain breaks, certain. That's what I love about pieces like this. You have the tight, kind of thematic ensemble moments that frame the piece, and then you just let go in the middle and just have all kinds of like instrumental expressionism and stretching out. Sounds greasy now. I'm getting more kind of like they're cleaning up here. Hear those sustained organ notes? Yeah, that was Lenny White with an all-star Latin jazz rock cast doing Chicken Fried Steak from White's 1975 album, Venusian Summer. And let's hear another track from the album. Mostly the same people, but the same bassist, Doug Rauch, and Doug Rodrigues and Lenny White, continuing on the next track with some other people that I'll be introducing as the track goes along. Away Go Troubles Down the Drain. Now we got some like hi-hat. Some really wiggly synthesizers. I love that wiggly sound, how it's like interacting, how it's like wiggling through the bass line. It's almost like a worm in a coil. And I really love the organ too. The, electric piano and clavinet by Onaje, Allan, Gumbs. Yes, very familiar name. Was in Birthright. Yeah, the two great Birthright albums from the mid-70s. And Gumbs has a lot of great credits to his name from this time period. Let's see. Dark of Light by Norman Connors. Genesis by Charles Sullivan. Black Love by Carlos Garnett. Yeah, several actually Norman Connors titles. Free Spirits, the Birthright album from 1974. Sneaking Sally Through the Alley, Robert Palmer's debut solo album. Larry Ridley, I have every single one of these albums. Yeah. Buster Williams, Pinnacle. Some Woody Shaw titles from the time period. Ricky Boger, Slow Down Baby. Oh, that's a great album. Yeah, one that only came to my attention a couple of years ago, as a matter of fact. Art Webb, Love Eyes. Phyllis Hyman's first solo album. Yeah, The Nightbird Gets the Love. I did that song a few months ago. Yeah. Oh, God, this guy has a very impressive resume. Else that we're hearing right here. Okay. Gumbs is responsible for electric piano and clavinet, and organ is by another very distinguished jazz funk musician from the time period, Weldon, Irvine. Once again, that kind of dirty psychedelic tone. Kind of like a mixture of like wah-wah and, I don't know, kind of maybe a bit of distortion. And the bass line really just wiggling around. I love those kind of breaks. Oh, and what we are just hearing now, all that like watery, brimming synth Moog. Yeah, that is by the one and only Dave Sancious. Uh-huh. Yeah, a guy who with his backup band Tone released some great albums during the second half of the 1970s, and he has a lot of great credits. He was also on the musical director of Bruce Springsteen's second album, The Wild, the Innocent, and the E Street Shuffle, which might just really be the only Springsteen album I really care for. Getting beyond that, he going on to bigger and better things. In addition to his solo career, also appeared on at least one Phyllis Hyman album. Let's see, Patty Austin, Peter Gabriel are among some of the later credits to his name. But yeah, he was also on Garden of Lovelight, Nerado Michael Walden's first solo album, and Stanley Clarke's Journey to Love, and School Days. Uh-huh. Oh God, hear those brimming tones. And on a totally different note, he was on Stoop Faction by Graham Parker. Let's see, and Billy Squire's The Tale of the Tape, and Jack Bruce's 1980 album, I've Always Wanted to Do This. Oh, and John Anderson's animation album. God, this guy gets around. Yeah, a whole another list of albums that I know. I love this, like G7, I believe. Yeah, G, because it, yeah, I can hear the F in there. Yeah, got that. That's a great key center to be grooving around in. I love how you'll have like a few instrumentalists that are just like playing persistently throughout, and then a few others that are just kind of like trading off. Oh, hear that organ sound getting kind of icier, more trebly in this, and it's coming out like of my left. And the guitar getting a little bit thinner, kind of snakier. I'm also hearing a little bit of clavinet just boiling up, like bubbling up here and there. Those like organ, like oh. God, I'd love to see this. I wish I could have been there in the studio watching. I wish I could have been the fly on the wall in the studio just when this was recorded. Yeah, three great keyboardists, you know, on one recording. It's, yeah, he really knows how to. Lenny White really knew all the best musicians in the industry. He just really pulls it all together here. God, there's another track on here where he's got Patrick Gleason. Yeah, the title suite. That'll be something for another installment. Yeah. We just heard Away Go Troubles Down the Drain, and before that, Chicken Fried Steak by Lenny White from his 1975 debut solo album, Venusian Summer. Yes, Lenny White, the celebrated drummer of Return to Forever, Mark II. Yeah, one of the greatest jazz rock, jazz funk bands ever, and also very serviceable, very highly skilled and high demand session musician throughout the decade. One of the best in his class. Yes. For more Rubies and Sapphires from the catalog of Lenny White, see the directory of albums by American jazz funk artists linked in the description below. For Red Hot Tracks and Tasty Purples from this album and several little ones after it, you know, in his catalog, as well as albums by like-minded artists, well, similar drummers in kind of the same league as him, like Alphonse Mouzon and Billy Cobham. Yeah. And many other artists, including many of the ones that I mentioned in here, like Weldon, Irvine, and yeah, and a few people, David Sancious. All each of them have albums on there as well, in that directory, over 500 albums strong currently. Like and subscribe and follow me on social media and leave a comment if there are any observations you have about the two tracks we just heard, the layers, the soloing, the sounds, the tones, the interplay, the counterpoint, the harmonics of it all, just the overall vibe and feel that it conjured up. Yeah, and until next time, this is Aragon, the world's most ear-traveled trimaximalist, signing off.